The called Christians, the lukewarm Christians, are the ones who are going to be persecuting the true Christians. It's coming, my brothers. It's coming. And these Christians who seem to be Christian, but they are behaving like the world, they are coming for you, true Christians. They're coming for you. It's very true, they're coming for you. Because the Bible tells us, these people, they'll be spit out by God. And think about someone who is coming with some anger of being spit out. How much anger will he have? He'll be coming because, you see, the Bible tells us one thing. There's something called a reprobate mind. Reprobate mind is when you start, let's say, for example, you start smoking. You continue smoking, you start drinking, you start taking smoking bang, you start taking cocaine. And as you go, you're getting in deeper and deeper and deeper. And as the time comes by, you are now in another world that you cannot even explain. You have a reprobate mind. Think about people who fornicate. You'll be with someone today, tomorrow someone's wife, the other day like this, the other day you're in the street looking for a whore, the other time you continue, you start becoming changing. By the time you realize, you've even changed yourself. You're no longer the man you are. Now you're a woman. Are you seeing the way something you call a reprobate mind? And people don't understand that this one is happening right now as you're living right now in the world. And it is a time, my brothers and my sisters, for you to make a decision. You have to make a decision. Am I going to be left or south? I mean, left or right, north or south. It's a time that you understand and ask yourself, where am I going to be? Because where you will be, that is what is going to blow up. So if you're hiding yourself at the middle, that's what's going to blow up. Now, let me tell you why the Bible tells us you either be cold or you be hot. Do you realize when you go to a church, for example, which is all cold, what's going to happen to you? You don't hear the word of God, or maybe you've just gone to some church of Satan or somewhere which is purely no God. What are you going to do? You're going to jump out because that place is cold. And you're going to say, no, I this is not right. Let me go and look for the true church because it was cold. If it's hot, you will say, thank God, here there is God. But what happens when you go to a church whereby you can't really tell is hot or is cold? It's warm. What you do is, like we all do, whenever you're in your blanket and you feel some warmth, you sleep. You sleep and you'll never realize yourself. You'll never realize when the time of Christ coming is going to be. That's why the Bible says you rather be in the world or in Christ. Because when you're totally, completely in the world, deep down in your mind, you know, I am lost. And at some point, I know God is going to do something, just like the prostitutes and the thieves and the people in the time of Jesus. They knew they were lost, and that's why they were looking for Christ. And that's why you could see prostitutes being saved by Jesus. And you ask yourself, how comes this one's here? But look at the Pharisees. They were lukewarm. They were halfway here, halfway here. So they always thought, I am safe. There's nothing like playing safe nowadays. There's nothing like playing safe. You either be in the faith or out of the faith. Because if you're out of the faith, at least somebody's going to see you and is going to pursue you, at least to come back to Christ or to get to, you know, salvation. Or at least God is going to do something because you understand. Because the journey of salvation, it is in bits. And you are, the first thing for you to be saved, the first thing which has to happen for you to be saved is to understand that you're lost. Unless you understand you're lost, you can never be saved. You see, the people who are called, they already have that fact. They know, I know I am lost. I know I am lost. And I know at some point in my life, I'll need a savior. Because until you know you're lost, you can never desire to have a savior. And until you hear the gospel, you can never be able to be saved. Because the order of salvation is, understand that you're lost, hear the gospel, understand the gospel, believe the gospel, and then you confess what you've believed. That's the order of the of salvation. So those people who are already called, they already have one fact. They know that they are lost. They know that they are lost. But think about people who are lukewarm. They are here in the middle. They don't understand this or that. They're just at the middle. They don't know, am I here or here? I'm just playing safe. Have you seen the people in church nowadays that they're playing safe? They're playing safe so much. They're saying, oh, I don't want to be on the bad side of God. I don't want to be on the bad side of Satan. I want to play like the Pharisees. Let me tell you, the Bible tells us here in the book of Revelation, Revelation 3:16. Because you are lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will spit you out of my mouth. My friends, you're going to be spit out. You're going to be spit out. You rather ask yourself, where am I? Am I in the middle? Am I hot or am I cold? That's my message for you today. And if you don't still understand the gospel, please, the gospel is found in 1 Corinthians 15:1-4. Understand it and believe it. It's all about how that Christ died for your sins and he was buried and rose again the third day according to the scriptures. Jesus did this for you. He did so that you can be saved and you can have the true gospel. God bless you guys.